Imagine being able to move freely over your whole lifetime. That your body retains its strength and even your skeleton is not aging. It may sound like a dream, but this is actually the goal of Claes Ohlsson's research on our skeleton and the risk of osteoporosis with aging. The skeleton holds up our whole body, but it's not static. It's under constant reconstruction. Cells called osteoclasts break down bone, while those called osteoblasts build up bone mass. When one suffers from osteoporosis, the osteoclasts break down more than the bone can be regenerated, leading to fragile bones that break easily, which can impair the quality of life. But what if you could stop this process and get your bones to maintain their structural strength? Claes lives in Gothenburg and often trains down here by the sea. He knows that even something as simple as basic exercise is a good start for those who want to keep their bones strong.
The loading of the running activates the bone cells in the skeleton and makes it stronger. That's good.
But aside from exercise, much is still completely unknown about what other factors may affect our skeleton and why people suffer from osteoporosis. Claes is a consulting doctor at Sahlgrenska University Hospital and helps patients with osteoporosis, but hopes to be able to help many more patients through his research.
I feel that I'm, as a researcher, I can help many patients by understanding the causes of the disease and thereby maybe in the future prevent the disease.
Sweden is one of the countries with the highest rate of fractures per capita in the world. And the older we get, the greater the risk of adding to these statistics. But the cause of many of these fractures is complex. Claes and his colleagues need, therefore, to include research on a broad front.
Den här studiepatienten ser bra ut.
Ja, precis. Det ser man här väldigt tydligt att bentätheten har ökat avsevärt. Och samma sak gäller för höftbenet.
To solve the osteoporosis riddle, they search in our genes and hormones. But additionally, they are looking at our intestinal bacteria.
There are many different causes and we want to identify them so we can develop the best treatment for each individual patient.
Claes's team's research begins with resources from large biobanks with samples from over 1 million people.
Here you can see the DNA from more than 100,000 subjects that we have in our biobanks.
From there, they employ the help of artificial intelligence and couple the information on bone mass and the risk of fractures. By doing it this way, they have already succeeded in identifying several genes that may be behind osteoporosis. Now they move forward and take a closer look at our intestinal bacteria.
One might wonder why we should look on the gut microbiota and the skeleton, but the gut microbiota has a lot of effects on the different parts of the body. And we were curious about if it could have an effect on the skeleton as well.
Our gut bacteria are vital for our bodies. They control metabolism and the immune system. And the immune system is of particular interest when it comes to the skeleton, because it can affect the osteoclasts, which, as we saw earlier, are the cells that break down the bone. Is it possible that they could be affected by what we eat? After giving mice health-promoting bacteria, so-called probiotics, and seeing its effect of improving bone mass here, it was then time to try this on humans. They gave probiotic capsules to a group of women who had recently entered menopause, when the onset of osteoporosis is common. One test group received treatment with probiotics, while the other group received a placebo capsule without probiotics. After 1 year, it turned out that the placebo group with no probiotics lost bone mass as expected. But the probiotic-treated group had kept their bone mass completely intact.
The Gothenburg studies were successful. They showed an increased bone mass.
The results were sensational. Claes and his colleagues, Matthias Lorentzen and Clara Sjögren, were the first in the world to show that bacteria can improve our skeleton. Now they want to take this a step further and understand exactly which bacteria do what.
We think we can get larger effects on the skeleton. And to come to this, we think we should identify the good bacteria and maybe also the bad bacteria for the skeleton.
If Claes's team can locate the specific bacteria, they can also develop a completely new treatment for osteoporosis.
If we can identify the good bacteria, then we think we can develop a second generation probiotics, a health-promoting mixture of bacteria that can slow down the aging of the skeleton.
What sounds like a pipe dream may actually come true. Claes's research team's discoveries among our genes and bacteria might be the missing link to maintaining a strong skeleton and our mobility for life.